take a shot every time she says dollars and not simoleons. Hey guys, how's it going? So today we're back with another build challenge and we're going to build a $5,000 simoleon house versus a 500,000 simoleon 5,000 simoleon house versus a 500,000 simoleon house. So we're gonna get right into it. If you guys like the video, please give me a thumbs up. Leave any comments or suggestions you may have in the comment section down below. And yeah, let's get into the video. Okay, so I'm gonna be building here in Brindleton Bay. This is actually where the museum lot is, and I feel like it's gonna be really pretty for what I'm going for here. I'm going to build a massive $500,000 farmhouse style family home, I guess. And then in the back, we're gonna have this little barn that maybe they've renovated into a guest house or a grandparents' home or something in the back. So that's where I'm gonna go. That's the vibe we're going for with this. I'm sorry, I got my nails done and I'm just like, boom, 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 boom. I've also kind of set it for live mode. So we're gonna be in fall in my game, which I'm kind of feeling the vibe, not gonna lie. Normally I like bright and colorful, but I'm feeling the fall vibes. So we're gonna go for it. So I've set my budget to 5,000 simoleons. I'm gonna go ahead and build my shell back here. It's gonna be pretty small. And I was hoping to be able to go for like a loft style. So I want to do two floors, but I think, no, there's no way we're gonna be able to pull that off. No way. Okay, so this is what I got so far for the outside of my little barn. I feel like it looks super cute. I've got windows going around. There's windows to the back. I put this lighting up here and this little fixture from Get Together. I love this thing. I love the vines going up the side. It's super pretty. So this is the outside so far. I'm gonna play around with some terrain paint and probably some debug landscaping to save some money, and then we'll go inside. I'm thinking about putting a pond next to my little barn, but it's literally bigger than my house, so I don't know if that's gonna look kind of weird. I am gonna put some little pumpkins out here. Again, really going with the fall vibe, I think. Cute! Oh, I'm excited for this. This is what I got for my outside of my little barn here. I think it's freaking adorable. So cute. Love the fall vibe happening. I did use a lot of debug. I hope that's not like too cheaty, but it is part of the game and under $5,000. So let's go inside. I really want to start working in here. It is very, very small. I'm hoping that I'll be able to fit everything we need. I think I'm gonna do a little bathroom and the rest open concept just to kind of like save money a little bit. I'll save my windows and then yeah, we'll kind of just use like a divider to kind of barrier off the bedroom or something, which we could put possibly back there. Gonna go for a very cozy vibe in here. I think one light is gonna be enough to brighten up the whole place because it's so small. I need a door for my bathroom. We're gonna have to go really cheap for pretty much everything else. There we go. I think I can fit my bedroom back there and then kitchen, dining, and living room over here. We have just over $1,000 left. These beds are $25, but they're so gross. I think used futon might be the way to go, so maybe I can grab like one of these, stick that over there. Yeah, this looks like a perfect area for my little bedroom back there. I'm at $899. Uh-oh. Maybe we're gonna have to like shrink this a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna try and get my bathroom stuff and my kitchen appliances, anything that's pretty expensive, get it out of the way and make sure we can afford it. We're gonna have to go for like all of the used items here. Everything will be used. Counters are gonna be used. It's used oven. Got my really cheap bath sink there, and there we go. That's gonna be it for my kitchen. $336 left. And I don't even have flooring, tiles, or anything in my bathroom. We'll just use some good old paint in my bathroom. I'm gonna get my toilet, the cheapest one we got. Oh my god, I'm at $54. This is not gonna work. I'm gonna have to shrink this even more. I don't wanna get rid of my cute outdoor decorations. No. How much is this? $140. This thing is like $325. How have we already spent so much money? I'm so confused. Okay, instead we're gonna go with our spooky stuff. Paneling, our wood paneling outside, that saved us a little bit of money. I kind of like that better actually. Okay, I got rid of my little window things. I'll just move these over, make it look nice and pretty. $538. We got this. I need a bathroom. This will be my shower and that's gonna have to be my sink. Oh my god. Nice little mirror there. We're not going for the essentials. No toilet paper, no towels. This is where our eco lifestyle stuff is gonna have to shine. So I think I'm gonna use this shelf somewhere and that will hold up my cheap TV that we're gonna use. This TV is only $25, so I'm gonna raise this up, put it on my shelf. $33. I need a light for my bathroom still. Oh my God. Okay, I have to save money somehow. Maybe I'll delete a window. That's gonna be our bathroom light. Super cheap. $23. Okay, I've changed my wallpaper to the spooky stuff as well. I am desperately trying. Desperately trying my best here. I think I might even like give us a little accent wall for some variation here. Wow, that little couch there was $190. I have $1 left. No! What if instead we use two of those little chairs and then we can afford a rug? Actually, these are free. Debug rugs are free. Oh, let's use a couple. I feel like that vibe's gonna be super cute. What can I use to decorate in here that's free? Maybe I'll add some more of these little cute pumpkins. I think they're freaking adorable. We'll just stick those over there. Get like this guy as well. Cute. Just some cute little things on the wall there. What else? How far can I stretch this? The bathroom is just done getting love at this point. They're not getting anything. I have $11 I can spend. What are we gonna get for $11? Maybe some more decals? That was $5. I mean, maybe it's like a teen that wanted to move out but couldn't. So now they live back here. Again, stretching. I don't know. There? I mean, it looks pretty freaking cozy to me. I don't know. I think I'm gonna move on. There's not a whole lot happening in here, but $5,000. I think the outside is definitely my favorite. It is really adorable for $5,000. So let's work on the $500,000 home now. I'm gonna set my budget. $500,000. Let's do it. So I'm gonna go ahead and start my shell here. Again, we're gonna go for big family, like farmhouse style home. So that's gonna be the goal here. I'm also gonna try and spend as much money as I can on the outside, so that when we go inside, we don't have to deal with so much tacky, expensive furniture. So I want these to look kind of similar in terms of like the colors that we use and stuff. So I'm using the same kind of roof, maybe the same kind of color trim. And so far, this is kind of the shell of my house here. It's pretty big. We'll see how this goes. Gonna try and go for a pretty big porch. I'm gonna use these pretty expensive columns here. I feel like these ones don't look too bad, especially since the like top part is hidden. The marble stairs aren't the worst thing either. So let's use those. And then for my railing, we'll go like that. I want to have a big, beautiful door, so I'll use that one, I think. $600 for that. For my windows, I'm going to try and go like a little bit overboard with them because these are $230, and the more that I spend, the better. We're going to add a cute little door back here. That's going to be our porch, and I'm going to find some really expensive wood like this. That's going to be our deck. Also going to fence around this entire lot. I know that that can end up being quite expensive, so I think I'm going to try this. That was $9,000. Ooh. I'm not gonna lie, I'm kind of falling in love with this lot. I really, really like it, with a driveway leading back there, the cute little barn. Gonna add the most expensive chimneys we can find on here. Ooh, this is pretty, pretty much it. I think we can use some actual flooring leading up to my home. I literally never do that. We spent a decent amount on the outside here. I'm gonna start my landscaping. This is without landscaping, lighting, or anything. So let's get started on that. My goal here is to spend at least $100,000 on the outside. The landscaping is coming along. I feel like it looks super cute. Using a lot of these like pine trees. Normally, I really don't like that some of the landscaping is dead, but right now I don't hate it. Back here, I think I'm gonna create this super beautiful outdoor dining area. Look at this backyard. Normally, backyards are not my favorite thing to do, but this is quickly turning into one of my favorite builds, I think, like ever. And we haven't even gone inside yet. $1,000 for that guy right there, and it looks like it could be a perfect little outdoor table. I need some chairs that are gonna be pricey, but not ridiculous for an outdoor dining area. Kinda like this. That's so pretty. I need to put like candles out here, decorate the table, make it look super pretty. There we go, look how cute that looks. I love that. Okay, I'm gonna show you so far what I've got. So this is the outside of the home. It looks so beautiful. I'm really excited about this. The landscaping looks so pretty as well. All the way around the back, we've got the hedges and the really pretty purple and yellow plants that I kind of went with. This is the backyard so far. And we've got our little pond, landscaping around the pond back there, our little lights on the fence. I've added these little chandeliers inside my patio, so I'm gonna start working on the patio here. I'm almost at my goal. I've got $24,000 to go. So far, I've got my super cute little couch seating area with the fireplace outside. I want this to definitely look lived in. This one is for sure going to be very, very lived in. Nice big expensive rug out here. This is basically like a living room, a full-fledged living room. All we need is a TV, which realistically we could probably put. I mean, if we're going bougie, I'm gonna spend this $10,000 TV here, put that on the wall, and shrink it right down. I'll even make it look like it's meant to be outdoors with a little plant thing around it. Cute. All right, going over to the other side, let's go and do something similar over here, but maybe not quite. We could actually stick like a whole bar over here. This is definitely gonna put us over our limit. That part cars, $3,000. Oh, over here we'll put actual pumpkins that you can buy. Maybe some of these like fall decorations behind the bar. I think I'm gonna put these over on the fireplace as well. And then look at that, we have passed our goal. On this side, let's put a speaker because it won't get wrecked in the rain. Over here, I've got my barrels. We've got our VIP bucket. This is our little patio here. I think we're maybe good to go inside. Let's go in and make a layout out of this. This house is gonna be massive. Okay, this is kind of the layout that we're gonna go with. So we have a big wide open living room, kitchen, and dining, hopefully. If we can't fit the dining there, I'm gonna stick the dining on this side. In the back, I think I'm gonna add some skill items or something, but that's basically just gonna be leading you out into the patio. And then of course a bathroom over on this side. And then upstairs, we're gonna have our little hallway. We're gonna have a bathroom and then two bedrooms. So I'm gonna start with the most expensive items first and then we'll work our way around. So basically like kitchen items, bathroom items, things like that. So obviously we're gonna use the most expensive fridge we can. We're gonna use the most expensive counters we can. And again, the goal is to hopefully keep this looking really cute and not tacky with the expensive build items in this game. So sometimes when I do these really expensive builds with big kitchens, I'll put a bar in there. So I've done that. I'm gonna add my oven. We're gonna make sure we have a thermostat there. I'll probably even put one upstairs in the hallway. I feel like that would make sense to have two, or is that not a thing? In a big house like this, I don't know, I don't own a big house, but I'm also kind of doing this before I do all of my flooring and wallpaper just to see what kind of colors I'm gonna use in my actual home. This is absolutely a backwards way to do this. I think I might even add another sink here. Again, I really wanted this to look lived in, so I'm trying to add little things here and there, like clutter items or like paper towel, things that would be in an actual kitchen. We're gonna add a dishwasher. I'm gonna add other things that I maybe wouldn't have normally added before, like we can add a coffee maker or a big espresso machine that is huge. Oh, microwave, that's expensive. Wait, oh god, I don't know about this one. I really don't know about this. The colors are questionable. It's fine, it's gonna come together. Okay, there we go, there's our kitchen so far. Let's move on. Then yeah, I think formal dining room is definitely gonna be over there. This is the most expensive dining table we have, so I think I'm gonna go with this. We are definitely going for like an older style here today. It really feels like an older couple with a lot of money who own this farmhouse. And then yeah, maybe they have a teen nephew or something that came to live with them and they live over in that barn. That can be the story that we're going with. The artwork in this game, we haven't really dove into any of that again because a lot of it I don't really like. I don't hate like the cats and dogs ones. Like these ones are pretty cute. I think we'll use those probably. Even this like base game one I think we could use. But I'm going with like a green and like yellow vibe here today. Got our super pricey little ship going on up there. Cute. I actually don't hate this. Normally when I'm doing an expensive build, by this point I'm so over it that I just start tossing things in that cost money. We're gonna load this place up with so many plants, all of the plants. I think I'm even gonna stick some in that bay window right there. Just kind of like sneaking in back here to put the plants on my bay window. I couldn't raise them up in there, but we'll do that. Maybe I could put pumpkins in there. Oh, that's cute. Okay, and now that I think about it, I feel like Patchy should be in here, like the seasons guy. The scarecrow. This guy, where can he go? Maybe we'll stick him over here. Oh, we should add leaves. Oh man, I'm gonna get carried away for sure. I'm gonna try and make like a really nice spread on this dining room table. Like maybe they're preparing for like a Thanksgiving dinner if they celebrate it or like something like that. I think those curtains are gonna look a lot better in here than the ones that I had. So let's go with those. I feel like my dining room is kind of coming together. I might leave it and come back to it in a little bit. But there we go, that's our dining room. Super cute, ready for fall. I'm gonna come over and do my living room next. Thinking about using some eco lifestyle maybe. Oh, I need a door for my bathroom before I forget. Okay, for my living room, I think I'm gonna put my couch here, maybe my TV over there. I can definitely fit a fireplace over on this side, so I think I'm gonna put that one there. And then we can mount up super expensive TV that we're gonna shrink down. I just got rid of that window so that we could add like bookcases to the side of this. There we go, that looks kind of cute. And then I'll put my couch over here. This is my living room. I'm kind of trying to pull together the colors. This is the basics, so I'm going to go ahead and decorate a little more, add some more plants and statues that are gonna cost $1 million. I kind of am on track, I think. Normally I get to this point and I need to spend the rest of the money like on the outside or I get really desperate. But right now I still feel okay. I still feel like we're where we need to be. I feel like you can literally like picture this couple. I've been trying to decorate a little more. I think it looks really cute. I'm gonna do the bathroom over here. This is going to take up quite a bit of money. We'll use this tile. $16 for that tile is not too bad. Maybe something like that for my bathroom. And then let's get my basics. Again, I don't want to have to use the gold toilet, but it's $5,000. Maybe if I go like that, it kind of fits in with the vibe a little bit better. Actually, when it's not like super gold and obnoxious, this isn't too bad. We'll get our little essentials. Oh my God, the color scheme in here is cracking me up. It's so bad. It's so old. Maybe I'll submit this for my spark challenge. Nice expensive shelf above my bathtub where I'm gonna put some cozy little candles and toilet paper, towels maybe. Okay, I think we're good for in our bathroom there. I'm gonna finish off this little room over here. Don't really know what I wanna put in here yet. Maybe like a creativity room or like a skill room or something. I also wanna add some more of this like outdoor stuff now that I've established that this is definitely an older couple living here or something. So we'll put the woodworking table out there. Maybe I'll put a pumpkin carving station since we've got so many pumpkins here. Oh, chess table for that other room maybe. Definitely fit that like right here by the window. Oh, we could put laundry. Get a little laundry station going over here. Or should the laundry go upstairs? Maybe I'll put the laundry upstairs in this hallway and then this can be like a knitting area or something like that instead. So we'll put our cute little rocking chair over here with like a bunch of cute little knitting materials. Maybe I'll put a shelf right there. A lot of this stuff is super bright, and although my favorite thing to do is use like bright colors, that is not what I'm going for here today. I think I'm gonna add another window in here so it's kind of got the vibe of like a sunroom almost, but not. This is cute. That's a cute little room there with a chess table on the side. I like it. All right, I'm gonna go upstairs and we're gonna figure out what we're gonna do up here. We've already got our little laundry area, which is perfect. We could go like that for our wallpaper. This is what I've done for my little hallway area so far. I think I'm gonna add maybe a computer desk actually right over here. All right, so that's the most expensive one we got. I gotta find a really expensive computer. These are gonna be some techie elders here. $15,000 doesn't fit my vibe though, but $15,000, I think we're gonna have to do it. Maybe the nephew comes over and has a really high-tech job, just cannot afford a home. This is $5,000, so I can put a little treasure chest over there. Maybe there's, I don't know, storage in there or something. We'll put another globe up here, kind of to keep with the travel theme again. Okay, my desk area is kind of coming along. It's getting kind of cluttered up here, but I'm going to work on my bathroom here. I have two bedrooms that I have to get through, and then we're gonna have to start spending money where we can here. So this bathtub is $12,000. I think I might actually replace the one downstairs with it as well. That is real expensive, and that puts us under $200,000. This is also a bigger bathroom, so I think I could probably fit a shower in here as well. Definitely gonna use my really expensive toilet again. We're at $175,000, and we'll get my really pricey sink here as well. The lighting of this house is not doing my camera any justice. Apologies. All right, bathroom looking cute. I'm gonna move on to the bedrooms. $168,000 left. I think I'm gonna go with the Princess Cordelia bed. I can't commit to this one. It's just not gonna fit the vibe. I'll squeeze in my little night tables over there to the best of my ability. Let's try that, I guess. We'll have to stick with the older theme with that dresser over there. What else can I put in this freaking bedroom? I've been trying really hard to not reuse the same pictures because I feel like that would be kind of unrealistic, especially when they're this expensive. So far, I don't think I've repeated any. I mean, different swatches is something else. Like, these don't count, but still. I think I'm gonna do two different dressers because if there's a couple living here, I feel like that kind of makes sense anyway to have two. The grandfather clock. Ooh, I want to put that somewhere. I think I can squeeze that right in there. Those are so cool to me. Those clocks are actually $1,200 and they're really small. So I'm gonna put a couple, maybe even one like outside. I think I put one in like every room, but they're so little. Okay, I'm gonna move on over here. My thought process here is that this could possibly be a bedroom where someone has moved out already. So I'm gonna put bedroom like stuff, but then I'm also gonna put gym equipment in here. So it's gonna be like they've transformed this room into a gym. So actually maybe this one could be a little more bougie. I'm gonna say this is probably not the same person that lives in the barn over there. This is gonna be like the only room in the house that's just like super extra. But then we're gonna have gym equipment over here because they don't live here anymore. So let's get some of that. Hopefully I can fit it in here. I kind of feel like that makes sense, especially for like an older couple. I'll add a little TV right here in front of the treadmill. We're under $100,000. Ooh, I'm so excited. I think I'm gonna even use this room as storage as well. So maybe on top of the bed, I can put like some of these because obviously no one is gonna be living here if they've moved out. So I could put like a treasure chest. Maybe I'll put some boxes, kind of make it look a little realistic. Old camera equipment even. The money under the bed. $76,000 left. What else can I put in here? I'm starting to get very, very desperate here. You know what we still haven't used yet? The $15,000 violin. That eats up so much money. Perfect. Okay, maybe I'll get rid of some of this stuff and we'll buy some cameras. They like to travel, so it makes sense that they would have these big cameras like that. Maybe this person is like the perfect trophy kid, and that's why their place is so expensive, so bougie looking. So maybe I'll give them a whole bunch of trophies and stuff. Okay, $44,000 left. I'll put a huge mirror in there. Maybe that used to be like a dresser area or something. I can add to our little gallery wall of like people over here. Could be like relatives or something. You know what I'm going to do? Because I don't want to fully commit to a huge night, I'm gonna shrink it and put it on their shelf. I feel like that adds to the tacky look when it's a massive bunch of knights outside the door. I feel like that's not the look I'm going for, but if we shrink them down, it actually might be kind of perfect. Same as like this, I can shrink that down, put it on my little shelf here. $18,000? Maybe I can add a guitar in the bedroom or something. That's $2,400, okay. Maybe one of the elders that lives here really enjoys music and that's why they have a $15,000 violin. I'll put an easel over here too, kind of adding to the vibe of the outdoor vibe. I'm stretching, I'm outside now. This is when you know you're kind of cutting it close. Robot vacuum, I can maybe like stick right under there. Super subtle, hiding. $10,000. I'm gonna start, I'm desperate enough to start including like actual Halloween decorations. A wreath on the door. How much is this? $50. Okay. Cute though. Maybe I'll add one on the other side too. I've added this thing to my dining room and look at, oh my goodness. That's like $9,000 right there. Wait, is there one that's exact? No. Okay, $9,000. A golden plate in a dining room for people that love to travel makes sense to me. We are now at $356. An urn is weird, but it kind of makes sense for old people, I guess. $56. How about 55? Done. We're done. This is huge. Okay, so we have finally finished this $500,000 home here. I am super, super happy with it. I feel like it turned out so cute. Even with this cute little barn in the back, the $5,000 barn, we have come a long way from that. So this is a $5,000 barn. Again, very, very adorable. I love it. Let's go inside. This might be like a nephew or something that has moved in with these elders that live in this beautiful $500,000 farmhouse. It is so gorgeous. The inside is just screams old, vintage, but also very expensive, very, very pretty. I'm definitely gonna submit this for my Spark Challenge. This is, this took me a long, long time. Let me know which one you guys like better. I personally still really love the little barn, but this, I mean, come on, this is a monster here. Let me know what you think, guys. This will be on the gallery under City Macaretta, and yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. All right, guys, that's it for today's video. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and leave any comments or suggestions you may have in the comment section down below. If you're looking for more build challenges to watch, I will link that playlist down below so you can binge those as well, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.